Well, on Monday's show, we told you about a potential new permit being introduced for dog walkers, with one Sydney council flagging a $550 annual fee for professional dog walkers who want to use the council-owned park. Well, one of our viewers was so outraged to hear this that she's come on the show to share her thoughts. It's Melinda from Brisbane. Really? Hello, Mel.
Thank you for letting me, a very humble home viewer from Brisbane of all places, speak on your wonderful program here tonight. And I encourage all viewers of the project to do the same. If you've got an issue with a story that you have seen on the show, it's quite simple. You get in contact with your agent and you ask for your own weekly segment. It's not hard.
Not hard email address, you know.
Not hard at all. So what do you got for us, Mel? You used to be a dog walker. Were there any regulations like this back in your day?
There was absolutely nothing of the sort, Waleed. To get into the industry, you know what I had to do? I had to make a Facebook page and I had to buy a dog lead. And then that's it. You're off. And before I knew it, I was walking dogs. And, well, I wasn't really walking them. I would take them to cafes whilst I was wearing leggings and I had a bum bag. So similar to walking.
Well, I mean, that doesn't sound like you took it very seriously, Mel.
I struggled. I did struggle, Sam. I once took a French bulldog to the vet, this dog that I was walking called Ziggy, because I thought she was choking, but that's just how they sound. They're just like... So, $140 down the drain. But I had to take precautions because those dogs are expensive. They can be $6,000 each. Now, that is not a dog. That's a used Toyota Corolla.
Yeah. Well, do you feel sorry for the dog walkers, or is it all fair in a dog-eat-dog economy?
Oh, nice, Kate. Well,
best in the business there, Kate.
Yeah.
Look, I will say this. If anyone's had it too good for too long, it's self-employed casual workers. It is high time the council cracked down on these people a little bit harder. And forget about big business. If we're going to balance the nation's budget, it will be on the backs of dog walkers. I'm joking, obviously. It's revenue raising at the expense of the small business owner, and I feel like Steve Price saying that, actually.
Oh, watch out, you're Steve Price in a skirt. Hey, you've come a long way since your dog walking career. Do you engage a professional to walk your dog these days, now that you're famous?
Thank you for calling me famous, Sarah Harris. It means the world to me. No, I've got a dog with mental health issues and low self-esteem. Oh. Where does she get that from? That's crazy. Ruby isn't great in group situations either. And again, where do they pick this up? But poor little Ruby. She did have a bit of a hard start to life. So she's a rescue, which means I'm better than you. Yeah. And she's afraid of curtains.
Well, how do you exercise her then, Mel? Do you take her to the dog park?
No, she can't go to the dog park. Well, I can't go to the dog park because I can't take the oodle, poodle, doodle people seriously. Like, I'm sorry, but your dog looks like a shower cap rooted a mop. I'm so sorry, but, you know. Ruby, my dog, she's a mixed breed dog, so there's always some bloke that looks at her and goes, oh, does she have a bit of staffy in her, does she? And I'm like, I don't know what she's eating today, mate. I don't know.
Oh, thank you very much, Mel.
Thank you, our leaders. It's been my pleasure to present this Future Walkley award-winning piece here tonight.